Students, today we will discuss about the pass 2 of the assembler algorithm. So in previous class we have discussed about pass 1 algorithm. Okay, so in pass 1 we have converted from assembly language to intermediate file. So then after that, from intermediate file to we need to convert object code. So that is in pass 2. So before discussing pass 2 assemblers, I need to discuss some revising the few things whatever I have discussed in previous class. So we know that we have two pass assemblers. It means when you are converting from assembly level language to machine level language, it contains two passes. So here, okay, two passes in assembler that makes two pass while converting from assembly language to machine language, that one will call it as a two pass assembler. In first pass, what we have done, the assembler scans the whole source program and it will find the address of each label defined in the program. Okay, so that is in symbol table we have stored the address of each label and it assigns the address to each instruction. Okay, so this is the two things what we have done in pass one. So in second pass, in pass one we have made a assign the address, that's all instruction. We have assigned the address to instruction and assigned the address to labels. In pass two, what we are doing, we scan the whole source program to obtain the machine code for each instructions and finally generate the object code. Actual object code is in pass 2. So here intermediate file will be converted to object code. This is the two in second pass we had. So we already know that the data structures used in the design of assemblers are three data structures: operation code table, that one we call it as a op code. So in that we have an instruction and the corresponding op code is present. Okay, so I have already discussed those things. Then location counter, it contains the address of each instruction, and symbol table, it contains the address of labels. Okay, so these are the three data structures we are using in assembler. Okay, so then this is very, very important in pass 2. So I already discussed what are the three types of records are present in object program in the previous class. Okay, so there are three records in three formats in object program. One is header record, text record, and end record. Okay, header record, text record, and end record. So header record contains what? Okay, so it contains a program name, starting address, and length of the object code. Three things it contains, header record. So header record contains the program name, starting address, and length of the object code. These are the three things it contains. There should be only one record in object program. So we should have only one header record for each object program. So header record contains these things. That is, in column 1 we'll have H indicates the header record. Okay, column number 2 to 7 it will be program name. Column name 2 to 7 it will be the program name, and column 8 to 13 it will be starting address of the object program, and 14 to 19 it will be the length of the object program. These are the four things. One is column 1 is header, H it indicates the header record. Column 2 to 7 it will be the program name, and 8 to 13 it will be starting address of object program, length of the object program. So it means three things: header record contains program name, a starting address of object program, third one is the length of the object program. These are the three things contains header record. Okay, so then when you come to text record, in the text record contains the machine codes along with the program data. So it contains the machine code along with program data. That is, machine code is nothing but an object code. So there can be one or more text record in object program. So here these are the contents what we have in text record. The column number 1 it will be T indicates the text record. Column 2 to 7 it will be the starting address of object code in the text record, starting address of object code. And 8 to 11 length of the object code. Okay, so then 10 to 16 object code can maximum size of 30 bytes we can contain the text. Okay, that is starting address, length of the object program, and object code. These are the three things contains the text record. And last one is end record. End record indicates the end of the object program. Okay, so end record indicates the end of the object program, and it contains the starting address of the first instruction to be executed. Okay, so two things, that is starting address of the first instructions to be executed for that object program. So these are the three records we are using. So these three records, header, text, and end record, these are the three things we are using in pass 2 assembler. Now come to pass 2 assembler algorithm. Okay, See here, in past assembler, in past one, we are converted a whole source program in intermediate file. Okay. So here, start from that intermediate file. So assembly to intermediate file has done. Okay. So now intermediate to object code is converting in past two. Okay. So here, what we are doing in past two. Okay. So first, we will read the first input line. So that is from intermediate file. We have read the input file. Okay. So here, if the input line, that is in that if opcode is start. Okay. So usually a program start from start. Okay. So here, if opcode is start, then begin write listing line. Okay. So it means you are write in the listing line, that is in the object line, object code. Okay, in a final object program, in that you should write listing line and read the next input line. Okay, so if it is start, copy that one to object file. Okay, object code, then read the next input line, and if ends, that's all, end. Okay, so next, okay, if start comes, copy that one to listing line, that's all. Okay, copy that one to next object line. Okay, that is object code, and then read the next input line, that's all. Okay, so then next after end starts. Okay, so you know, ending of that start. So now write header record to object program. So header record, why I am explained that one, header record contains, okay, so that is H indicates the header. So then you know, program name, so then after starting address and length of the program name. So those are the length of the program. Those things contains the header record. Okay. So write header record to object program. Okay. So you should write that header record to object program. Okay. So initialize the first text record. Okay. So header record, text record contains the actual text. Okay. So initialize the first text record. So header record, write the header record to object program, then initialize the first text record. Okay. Done. Write header record to object program and initialize the text record. Done. Okay. So now till opcode is not equal. So end, where we will write end. So end will be right at the end of the object program, you know, at the end of the program. Okay. So till you need to do these steps till opcode is not equal to end. Till that you need to do. So first begin. If this is not a comment line, okay, so we are using comment line. If it is comment line, we won't change anything. So if it is not a comment line, then what we need to do, we need to search for search op tab, operation table. So the operation tables contains what? It contains instruction and opcode. Okay, search for op tab for opcode. Okay, so in op tab, we'll have an instruction and corresponding opcode is there. So okay, search op tab for opcode. Okay, if opcode is found, then if there is a symbol in the operand field, so I got an opcode. So in that, if we have a symbol, if there is a symbol in operand field, okay, if there is a symbol we found, then search for symbol table for operand. Okay, search symbol table for operand. If found, if okay, in SymPand, if symbol is found in SymPand, the SymTab, then what you need to do, you need to store that symbol value as a operand address. Okay, so you need to store that symbol value as operand address. Okay, so here you are using a labels, and labels you are when you are comparing. Okay, if it is less than 10, so then jump to that label. Okay, so that label address in symbol table, what we have, label and their address. Okay, so here if search for op tab for opcode, if it is found opcode, if that there is a symbol in operand field, then search for the symbol for operand. If it is found, then store the symbol value as a operand address. Else, okay. Okay, so if it is found sim tab in the sim tab, if you found that label, then store that symbol. Symbol is nothing but a label. Okay, so store symbol value as a operand address. If it is not found, store zero as operand address. if you are not found symbol in the sim tab, okay, so store 0 as a operand address. Okay, set error flag, that is undefined symbol. Okay, so you are declaring the variable, okay, declaring the label, but you are not using that label anywhere. So then what we need to do, you need to store symbol value as a operand address. Okay, so if you are not found, then store 0 as a operand address and set error flag, and this is the end of the symbol. Okay, so what we have done, okay, first start done. Okay, so if it we will start first, we'll read the input file. Okay, so that is intermediate file. If it is opcode is start, then what we need to write that line to write listing for line and read the next line, and that will be the end of the start. Then write the header record to object code, object program, and initialize text record to 0. That's all. And till the opcode is not equal to end. Okay, so what if it is not a comment line, we can't do anything, leave it. If it is not a comment line, search for the op tab, operation table for opcode. If it is found, then search for a symbol in the operand field. If it is found, okay, search for symbol table for operand. In that symbol table, if you got an operand, okay, if you got that label, then store the symbol value as an operand address. Okay, store the symbol value as an operand address. If you are not found, store 0 as an operand address, set error flag. If you are not getting that symbol in the symbol table, so they obviously you can initialize store 0 as an operand address and set error flag, that is nothing but an undefined symbol. You are not used yet that symbol anywhere. Okay, so it will be the end. Okay, so search for opcode. If there is an opcode, if you get an opcode in symbol table, search for symbol in the symbol table. If the symbol present in the symbol table, okay, so make it that symbol value as an operand address. If it is not found, store 0 as an operand address and set an error flag. That's all. Okay, so it will be the end of the symbol. Okay, else, okay, so the else store 0 as an operand address. That is also, if you are here, if found, store the symbol value as an operand address, else begin store as an operand address, set error flag. Okay, so if you are not get the end of the symbol, okay, so if it is end of the symbol, otherwise you should store 0 as an operand address. Okay, so then assemble the object code instruction. Okay, so assemble the object code instruction. Okay, so here symbol part is done, opcode done, then what we have, we will get a constant. Okay, so if you declared opcode byte in byte or a word, you will declare that constants. Okay, so here if opcode is found, that will be the end. So if opcode is byte or word, okay, so if opcode in program, you at the end you will a byte to C alpha word, you are declaring that one 20. So that like that you are declaring that variables, if okay, variables and constant. If that constants, if opcode is byte or word, then convert that constant to object code. Okay, so if opcode is equal to byte or a word, then convert the constant to object code. You should convert that constant to object code. Okay, so if object code will not fit into the current text record, okay, so we will use format 3 or a instruction for format is 3 or a format 4. Suppose if the object code will not fit into the current text record, then write the text record write the text record to object program. Okay, if the object code will not fit to the particular current text record, write that text record to object program and initialize the new text record. Okay, if the object code will not fit into the current text record, then write the text record to object program and initialize the new text record. That one will be the end of the object code, that if it is not fit into that. Okay, so then add object code to text record. Okay, initialize the text record, then add object code to text record. Okay, then end of the comment, till if we are check na, that end of the comment line. So then write the listing line, write the, okay, so listing line means you are writing that object code and read the next input line. Okay, so like that you will do, and end when it end occurs, that indicates the end of the program. So when it indicates the end of the program, then write the last text record to object program. Okay, so write the, when it end occurs, write the last text record to object program, write the end record to object program, and write the last listing line. Okay, write last listing line, that will be the end. So here when it end occurs, you need to do three things. Write last text record to object program, write last text record to object program, write end record to object program, write last listing line. Okay, so these are the three things. Okay, so what we have done in this pass two, okay, when you made a summary, so first we will read the input line. If it is start, okay, if opcode is equal to start, what we are doing, so initialize the you are writing that one to in that writing line, that is in objector, then that will be the, and read the next line, and that will be the end of the starter. If opcode is equal to, okay, okay, so if write the header record to object program, initialize the first record. If opcode is not equal to end, you need to do these things. If this is not a comment line, then you will search for the opcode in the op tab. Okay, if it is found, so then you need to search for the symbol in the symbol table. If it is found, okay, make that address as make that symbol address as the operand. Otherwise, you can put zero and set error flag. Starting address is zero, store zero as the operand address and set error flag. Okay, so then after that, you'll store the zero as a operand address. Okay, assemble the object code instructions. Okay, we'll have a number of instructions. Assemble the object code instructions. Okay, assemble means one after the other, you need to store the things. Then if opcode is byte or word, okay, get the constant, convert that constant to object code. If object, if opcode is equal to byte or a word, convert that constant to object code. If object code will not fit in the text record, okay, so write the text record to object program and initialize the new text record and add that object code to text record. Okay, so then after that, write listing line and read next input line. Okay, so when it end occurs, you need to do three things. Write last text record to object program, write end record to object program, and write last listing line. Okay, this will be the end of the pass two. Okay, so from this pass two, so what are all the observations we have done? Then what are the steps we have done? Okay, see here, these are the, if you know these observations, if you know these steps, you can easily write that algorithm. So first, what we have done, we will read the first input line. Okay, the first input line is read, and from the intermediate file. Okay, so we have done that. First we will read the input line. Okay, if the numeric field is a start, then this line is directly written to the listing file. Okay, listing file is nothing but an object file. Okay, if the numeric is start, you can directly, that line will be written to the listing file. Okay, so then after that, we know that header record consists of program name, starting address, and length of the program. Okay, written into object program. Header record consists of these three things will be copied to object program. Then first test record is initialized. Okay, so these things now we have done. So that is these four things we have till that we have done. Okay, so we will read the first input line. Okay, then after that, if the numeric field is start, then write the listing line and read the next input line. Okay, so then write header record to object program, initialize first record. Okay, so that is header record consists of program name, starting address, length of the object code is written into object program, and the first text record is initialized. Okay, the first text record is initialized. These steps we have done in that. What we have done, we have read the first input line. If the numeric field is start, we will write that one to listing file directly. That we will, we are writing the header record to object program, and first text record will be initialized. These steps we have done in the first part of that past. Okay, in second part, so we will search the opcode. Okay, then we will search for opcode table, that is we will call it a optab, search it for mnemonic. If mnemonic is found, corresponding opcode is obtained from the optab. If mnemonic is found, search for the opcode. Okay, so if mnemonic is found, its corresponding opcode is obtained from the optab. Okay, if symbol is present in the operand field, okay, so if symbol is present in the operand field, the symbol is searched for symbol table. If it is present, get the address of that symbol. Okay, if symbol is present, get the address of symbol, else display error message. That's all. Okay, if symbol is present in the operand field, okay, so then search for the symbol in symbol table. If it is found, get that address, otherwise display error message. Okay, so here if you search for the opcode in the optab table, if it is found, corresponding opcode is obtained from the optab. That's all. Okay, it means we are storing the opcode in in object file. Okay, if symbol is present, search for the symbol in the symbol table and get the address. Okay, if it is not get the address, display error message. That's all. Next, using opcode and address of the symbol obtained in the previous two steps, the object code is generated using appropriate format of the instruction. Okay, so you will get an opcode from the opt table. Okay, you will get the opcode from the opt table. Okay, so then address of the symbol we have obtained from these two steps. Okay, so then that object code is using these two steps, object code is generated using this object code, you know, using appropriate format. It may be the format 3 or a format 4. So using those things, we should generate the object code. Okay, so then that is the mnemonic, you know, optab and symbol table from two things. So then if the opcode is byte or a word, okay, if opcode is byte or a word, then constant value is converted into equivalent object code. If opcode is byte or a word, okay, so that one will be, then the constant value is converted to its equivalent object code. Okay, so that is the next step. If object code cannot fit into the current text record, okay, if object code is not, cannot fit into the current text record, what we need to write the text record to object program and initialize the new text record. Whatever the that status will be copied to object program, then after that initialize the new text record. Okay, so repeat these above steps till the end of the source program. Okay, once you get the end, okay, so then finally you need to do three things. Write the last text record to object program along with end record and write last line to listing file. Okay, write the last text record to object program. When it end occurs, you should, okay, when end occurs, you should write the last text record to object program. Write the last text record to object program. In addition to that, end record also, and write last line to listing line. Okay, write last line to listing line is nothing but an object program. Okay, so these are the steps. Three things. So first one is start. Then after that, opcode and symbol table. Then third one is this operand, that is byte or a word. Okay, so this is the third one, and if it is not fit into a current text record, you should copy to new, text record will be copied to object program and initialize new text record. Okay, so repeat these steps till the end of the program, and finally write the text record and end record and write last line to listing file. Okay, so once again I will tell the observations. Okay, the first, what we are doing, we will read the first input line from the intermediate file that is generated in pass one. Okay, so if the mnemonic field is start, okay, if the mnemonic field is start, then directly write that line to listing file. Okay, so if mnemonic is start, write the line directly to listing file. Okay, so that's all. If you get start, that is if opcode is equal to start, then you do this one. Okay, so then after that, copy the header record to object program, initialize the text record. This is the part one of the pass one, pass two. Okay, So read the first line. If opcode is symbol, directly write to our listing file. So then copy the header record to object program and initialize the first record. Okay. And after that, in second one, what we will search for the opcode in the op tab. Okay. So let me see, we will take the corresponding opcode for the mnemonic. Then search for the symbol in the symbol table. If it is present, okay, get the address of the symbol. If it is not present, display error message. From the opcode and the symbol, previous step, what you are, we are getting the opcode for the mnemonic and label address of the label, that is address of the symbol. Using these two things, we will generate the object code for the particular instruction. And we are in appropriate format, we are storing. That's our second part. Okay, so then after that, what we are doing, if opcode is equal to byte or a word, get the constant value. And get the corresponding equivalent object code. Done. Okay. If object code is cannot fit into the current text record, copy the current text record to object program, initialize the new text record. Okay. So repeat the above steps till the end of the source program. Then after that, once you get the source program, you should convert the, you know, you should write the text record, header record, and last line to the listing file. These things, if you then this one will be the pass to algorithm. This algorithm will be surely ask, okay, so, you know, 10 marks, 10 to 12 marks, they will ask this one. Okay, so this is also very, very important. Okay, so once again, you go through this, go through this observation, and same thing will be. So here, same thing, whatever observation made, same thing we have. Read the first input line. Okay, if opcode is equal to start, what you need to write directly that one to listing file. Read the next input line. Okay, that will end of the start. After that, write a header record to object program, initialize the first test record. These things only we did. Then till the opcode is not equal to end, if it is not a comment line, search for the operand in, you know, search for the opcode in the operand op table. If it is found, get that one. And if there is a symbol in the operand field, search for the symbol in the symbol table, get that address of that symbol. From these two things, okay. Okay, sorry, if it is for get these two things, we will generate a object code. Okay, so if it is you know, symbol is not present, so then store zero as an operand address, set error flag. Okay, that is done. Okay, so then that is assemble the object code instruction using those two instructions. Store zero as an operand address. Okay, assemble that object code instruction. That is from that operand and symbol. So we will generate the object code. Okay, that is nothing but assemble the object code instruction. Okay, so that is the second step. Then if opcode is byte or a word, convert that constant to object code. Done. Okay, so then if the object code will not fit in the current text record, copy that text record to object program, then initialize the new text record. That's all. Okay, then add the object code to text record. We have done. Okay, so write the listing line, read the next input line till end. Okay, so when end occurs, write the text record to object program, end record to object program, and last line to object. That is listing line. So this is the steps what we have. Okay, so kindly concentrate on this. So very easy. Okay, if you know the observations, so easily you can write the algorithm. Nothing is there, just if else part. Okay, if you write that steps, it will be easy. Okay, so when you come to observation, I will tell. So first we'll read the input line. Okay, we'll read the input line from the intermediate file. If that mnemonic field is start, or if it is start, then directly copy that one to listing file. Okay, and copy the header record to object program, initialize the text record. That's all. Okay, that is becomes a start. Then search for the opcode. Next one is search for the opcode in the operand, get that opcode, and search for the symbol in the symbol table. If it is found, get that address. If it is not found, set error flag. Okay, if it is found, from these two things, opcode and the start, you need to generate a new object code. That's all. From opcode and symbol table, you need to generate a new object program. That's all. So then after that, If opcode is byte or word, get the constant. Constant will be converted into appropriate equivalent object code. Then if object code is not fit into the current text record, write text record to object program and initialize the new text record. Done. Okay, repeat the above steps till the end occurs. When it end occurs, write the last text record to object program along with end record and last line. That's all. Okay, so this is the observation what we have done. Okay, kindly go.